I got too excited. Oh! Oh! Okay, hey, all the way from there.
They say forever, boy, girl, there's a love in this world, and I know.
This is nice,
eh? Hey, I'm good.
All right.
The heavenly touch of your embrace tells me no one could take your place ever in my
heart. I'm sorry, I'm not as fast as you.
Young love.
Sure. Yep.
Well, I should probably get going.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Before I forget, here, hold on to this.
My mama was a cold and callous woman and felt no remorse when she threw out all my old dolls.
Where are they? Where's Katie?
Burned up in the cans, I reckon. It could be too late, my grandma snitched. Our garbage bins were rusty old oil drums with the tops cut out. Strange bedfellows for summer flowers to nestle with. There they lay, in a pitiful heap at the bottom of the barrel. Katie, my firstborn, completely nude and one eye shut, the other half stuck in a traumatic gaze that pierced my cold, neglectful heart. Katie was my oldest and largest doll, and we'd been through a lot together. The judge, who presided over the court in my mother's dining room, often took her from me. With a harsh, silent, ghost-scream verdict of, "You are not fit to raise this child, you are too poor." The jury took her from me many times and locked her away in an orphanage. But I always recuperated and got back on my feet again, after much trial and error. I would don the purple silk kimono Daddy brought back for Mama from his stint in the Navy, so I would look rich. Finally, I was able to rescue her from the burning dormitory where she was institutionalized. We would leave stealthily in the night to start our lives afresh in another, friendlier climate, living for the first new weeks in the back of my mother's closet. I pulled potato peelings from her neck and chest and clumps of dust and cobweb from her hair and sat her down against the tall grass. She was not grateful, still in shock, but she would come around soon. She and I had a tortuous, undying love. Peggy, the smallest, suffocating in gray ashes and wadded newspaper, she whimpered pathetically. Katie had made no noise at all. They were as different as night and day. All my babies were. My only other child that I could save from the burning heap was Carol, my Tony doll I'd named after a favorite cousin, the only doll I ever spanked. I pulled her from the barrel in the charred remains of her purple kimono, just like Mama's that Grandma helped me sew, and laid her gently beside her sister's. I took my babies in the house and cleaned them up as best I could. They were clearly traumatized by their near-death ordeal, and it was a long time before we were really comfortable with one another again. Mama just laughed, of course, and said, I thought you'd outgrown them. She was a cold and callous woman and never understood much about motherhood.
Throw Mama from the train, a kiss, wave Mama from the train, a goodbye. Throw Mama from the train, a kiss, and don't cry, my baby, don't cry. Can't believe that she's gone now, it's a lonely old town, yet I know that her hair keeps looking down, 'cause whenever I happen to be passing through, I could swear she was there with the warmth I once knew. And I throw Mama from the train a kiss, wave Mama from the train a goodbye. Throw Mama from the train a kiss, and she throws one back from